Right?
I want to talk to you guys about this comic. We, a lot of time, I mean, every week we talk about our favorite comic books of the week. But this book, I can't tell you guys how important it is that you rush out to your comic book shop and pick up this book. It is called Alien 3, based, well, okay, before I can explain to you the importance of this comic book, and guys, if you haven't gotten it, rush out and get it. This is a monumentally important comic book you guys all need to get. But before I can talk about the book, I have to give you
a little bit of backstory.
A backstory on the movie Alien 3. Not the most widely loved of the Alien franchise, but it is probably my favorite of the Alien franchise because it's gorgeously shot. The comic book is not the movie.
Okay.
The movie, how do I even put this? The movie that everybody saw in theaters is not the original movie that was written.
Really?
It wasn't even the fifth version of the movie that was written. There were so many different screenplays for Alien 3. There was one where they go to Earth and it's like a Voltron thing where he melds with other aliens and becomes this big Godzilla creature. There's one where they go to a planet of monks and start murdering monks. There's one where he goes to this wood planet where everything's like made of wood and gears and cogs. All kinds of crazy stuff.
Wait, these were things that were going to happen in the movie?
They rewrote the script for Alien 3 dozens of times.
That's crazy.
They began pre-production with a director. He had his own idea for it. He dropped out. Sigourney Weaver didn't want to be in it, so there was a cut where she wasn't even in the movie. So the first director dropped out. Second director came in. Started pre-production on a completely different movie. They got all the way. They were building sets and they were doing all this stuff because they came up with this whole alien planet or this prison planet.
Okay.
Planet of prisoners, which is ultimately what the movie became.
Right. You said planet of what?
Prisoners.
Oh, just one more time.
Prison planet. And then, so they were full blown, ready to go. And then that director dropped out.
Oh my God.
And so they get this totally unknown director, this guy that was directing music videos only. An unknown director by the name of David Fincher.
Right?
David Fincher went on Fight Club, Social Network. Jesus, David Fincher. Everybody knows who he is now, but nobody knew who he was back in the day.
Seven.
They started out this movie with no script. They started shooting this movie. David Fincher was shooting a movie with no script. They were writing the script as he's directing the film.
And like giving
it was scriptless, Chuck.
Yes.
It was crazy. I mean, like, there's parts in the movie where a character will start out with an American accent, and halfway through the movie, he's got a British accent. I mean, the movie just evolved. Alien looked different in the beginning of the movie than he looked in the end of the movie. A lot of crazy changes.
Had a mustache at the end of the movie.
Yeah, everybody had mustaches, but at the beginning
CGI
with the
mustaches.
So why do I tell you all of this? The reason I tell you all of this is this comic book right here is a comic book adaptation of the original screenplay. The screenplay no one's ever seen, no one's ever read. The screenplay dropped online like about 2 years ago. No one had seen it. It is a legendary, it's the stuff of legend in Hollywood. It's the screenplay everybody says should have been done for the movie.
Wow, and it does not involve Sigourney Weaver, right?
So it's that didn't have Ripley in it, but it has Hicks. It has Newt. Because they die in Alien 3. Like, they don't even make it into the movie. They die in cryo sleep in the opening credits. So it has these characters returning back. I don't want to tell you too much about the story because it's absolutely spectacular. Any fan of Alien needs to check this out. Any fan
that's
of
so
film,
cool.
Period. It's the script for Alien 3 that should have been, is basically what it is. And it's spectacular. It's like this Cold War thing where the ship that they leave in Alien 2... Mm-hmm. Goes into like this weird Cold War territory of space. There's this big war going on.
Oh, wow.
They use the aliens as weapons. Everybody wants to get their hands on the aliens.
Crazy.
They want to use the aliens to kind of solve their Cold War. And it's only up to issue one. It's going to be, you know, I don't know, maybe like 5, 6, 10 issues. I don't know.
That's awesome.
But you got to check it out, man. Alien 3. It's actually called Alien. 20th Century Fox Uncovered Alien 3, the true unproduced screenplay.
Wow. That's so cool. What a concept.
It's amazing.
For all your face-hugging needs.
So guys, check it out. Alien 3. If you can still find a copy, I highly recommend you go pick one up.
Mm-hmm.
Moving on to movies.
Movies.
Huge.